Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of videos and recording about the Google Vertex AI. I will explain you what we had on the model garden, the models that we had there available and what we can do with them. So I had prepared a notebook as well today. We will see it at the end, how to interact with one of the models deployed from the model garden. Pretty similar to something that we did some days ago in another video, working with the Gemini Pro 1.5 Pro. But well, in this case I deployed a Llama 3 8 billions into Vertex AI, and we will later on interact with the model. So well, I assume that you have your Google account, your service account created, all this stuff we will not cover today. It's already covered in previous videos. And today we will go directly to the topic. We had the model garden, it's one of the options, and there you had all the models that are today in May 2024 available to be used either for inference or for to do some fine-tuning with your own data, and also use it as inference endpoint in Vertex AI. So you go to the model garden, and you essentially had pretty similar to what at least the main three cloud providers have organize the model repository, model garden. Well, every provider give a name to this service. From the perspective of which provider offers more, if I had to do a ranking, Azure is the first one, is providing around about 400 different models. Commercial and public access or public available from Hugging Face and commercial ones. You probably know that Azure have this agreement with OpenAI, and they had also OpenAI Studio as a service inside Azure ML. Then on we had Google. Vertex AI offers kind of is 69 models, all models of Google, like Gemini, and third-party commercial, like Claude 3 from Anthropic, or public ones like Llama 3, or Mistral 7B, or Stable Diffusion, BERT, and others, Roberta, Falcon, and many others, no? And the third one, it will be AWS through SageMaker or Bedrock, which today has the smaller offering in the model garden or model repository that they had integrated with their machine learning service. So what we can do? Well, we can use, as you see here, we had 69 models for deployment. You deploy this into Vertex AI infrastructure. For some of them, you have to sign agreement with the third party, as this is the case of Claude. Some of them are their own models, so you may need access as well, at least create the key to access in this case to the Gemini Studio. You want to access through this tool in Google. Some models, only 44, are fine-tunable. You can fine-tune those models. Many models, you can do it with Python or using the Python framework of transformers, and you can use it as well with one second So now they're using the Qlik framework or the Qlik library or other the Jazz library, but in any case, pretty easy as well to use. I will show you now. Well, we can start for this immediately. All this model comes with a some code or an output where you deploy the model into an inference endpoint in Vertex AI, and you can start to use them as app. It's pretty easy to do it. Let's take a look to another. The only that you need to take into account when you want to do a fine tuning. Let's take which one, Jax. For example, this. You can open probably the notebook here, and you need to take into consideration the quota. And these models used to consume a lot of resources. You will use as well the Colat Enterprise, the notebook service in Vertex AI, and you see all of them get you a notebook or some pieces of code just to deploy the model, the dataset always in a bucket in your project. And well, you have an example that is ready to go. The only thing that you need to take into account is the resources that you may need. Let me check where we have it here in this notebook. I didn't open it before, but at some point you will have the definition of the machines that you need to, or they are going to use to, here, Nano GPUs, Train Docker URI. Yeah, here you have a machine N1 standard 4 and a Tesla V100 and only one GPU. This probably I can train it in my machine, in my account, sorry, not in my machine. This is going to use essentially a container with this infrastructure template, only one GPU. Some others, let me show you here. I was trying to do this one to show you in this video, but I didn't have the enough quota to do it, so I didn't see. So here they have this resources. This is probably what they estimate that they need to do the training. To be honest, I did that. I used this. This is test classification with BERT. I did this in Azure ML, and I use a very small machine with only one GPU, with a T4, and I didn't need two GPUs for that matter. So maybe I can try just with one. I don't have quota to run it, and then I didn't do it. But the only thing I want to tell you with this is it's quite easy to do a fine tuning. You just follow the example. If you need to prepare a data set, you can bring out your own data. You have here an example. You can take this data and check how they prepare it. There is also a format if you want to do prompt, for example, you want to train a model for some specific tasks. That's it. So you just need to follow a little bit the example. It's quite easy to do here the parameters for the model, and then you just prepare parameters, each parameter worker specification, and you just submit the job. You just need to prepare the parameters to configure the job, and this is a conventional way to prepare a job for training in a platform which is providing machine learning as a service like its Vertex AI. Pretty similar to what others are doing, SageMaker or Machine Learning Studio. You had all the series of Machine Learning Studio, Azure Machine Learning Studio in the channel. You can take a look how how to train a model, how to create batch or online inference points, and you will see that it's pretty much the same. You just prepare the, you need a runtime, a server where you are running this Jupyter notebook, and then you just prepare all the parameters you need to submit to the endpoint where it is going to be to train, or to the container which is going to train the machine, and everything is ready to go. You don't need to change many things on that notebook. Just prepare the data set and adjust the parameters, the learning rate. Here 0.0 is not realistic, of course. You need to put something more appropriate, the batch size, the number of epochs, etc. And well, again, here you need to adapt this notebook just to the specific case you have, but the rest is exactly the same. And well, cleaning. So I didn't do that. I just deployed a model. But if you want, once I have the quota available, I will record a video where I can fine tune a model like this. It's not, I will try with this JAX, with this model, which I didn't see it before. But if I only need a GPU, where I have it, I already. Yeah, they are using the Flowers dataset. This is a computer vision model, a computer vision dataset, and we just JAX Vision Transformer. And well, the infrastructure they need is really smaller in comparison with what we need for the model I tried before. So I will try to do it. If the request is taking a lot of time, I will try to run this one with my current account, which for now, as I said, I don't have the quota to run with a model with two GPUs. Okay. And what's more, everything in these fine-tuned models, you have it fine-tunable models, you have it here. All of them again provide examples. And how to do it, you just need to adapt it, and it's gonna work quite straightforward. And the same you have here for organize the model for tax specific solution. And here in this group, you have models that you only can deploy to the endpoints, or also some models that are also indeed in this group that you can fine tune with your own data. You can also filter the models using this menu on the left, and then you can just take translation models, and then on for translation you have all these foundation models, 11, you have tax specific solutions. We don't have models to fine tune in this specific use case. If you take classification, you just had 17 models as foundation. Fine tunable, we have 26. Yeah, probably we have more if they are considering video and NLP. And task specific 15, probably this is. Some of them are included here. But I don't understand why. We had, yeah, here we had models. Let's take a look to what we have here. A lot of models is, this is text. Let's check how many we have. Language, 21. Run, 26. Okay. Okay, take a look and try to find if you had here. In my opinion, still a little bit far from what Azure ML is offering, and many models from computer vision, for the vision stuff, not many models from language, which that's fine to know. You see here, yeah, is what I say. Yeah, you have a lot that you can deploy, but to fine tune, you just had these two ones, which, well, you take a look to the to what we have for example, in Azure Machine Learning Studio, you had plenty of models to do any specific tasks. You can take a look to the videos I have on the channel for that specific matter. You can make the comparison with what you had here in Vertex AI and what you had in Azure ML. Okay, also you can deploy a model from Hugging Face. You just write here, for example, Google, and you can deploy a quantified base, and well, it's just filling all the fields for you. You need the access to the, you can here write the Hugging Face token if you need. Usually, well, in my case, as I'm using the same account, email account, for logging into Hugging Face and logging in this Google Cloud account, probably they are matching the accounts and I don't need to provide the model. You just adjust the names, adjust the region, check if in the region you have the proposed hardware, because, for example, I will provide you here, here, for example, they are proposing that, where is that, to use an NVIDIA L4. This is one of the newest offerings in Google. And we don't have it, at least I don't have it available in my region. So be careful, just keep this in mind. And also take a look to how much it costs the machine that they propose you to do the deployment, because they are not cheap. Yeah? A G2, and also as you can see here, let me check it out in London. Yeah, I don't have it even available on my machine. So this is crucial to let's check if we provide here the correct. Yeah, but they are not changing the title of the machine. I don't know what it will happen if we deploy this. I did it before, to be honest, and I didn't have any problem. Let's check it. But instead let me check. Google Plantified. Let's check it equal a T5. It's not available. How is not available? Give me 1 second. Yeah, well, some of the models are not available, so I don't understand why, because this model is publicly available in Hugging Face, and, well, it's not working here. Not understand really why, but okay. Yeah, you can just check if the model is there. You also can point to a public model, but I had some models, for example, this published in Hugging Face, but if you don't have the model card and also all the files that describe the model correctly set up in your repository in Hugging Face, this is not gonna work. So when you don't have this, you can go here, you can put your URL, but not working at all, because they are using these files. Let's go back to here. No, it's not this. 1 second. I will check. Plantified view hugging face. So you need to have correctly populated the model car, and also here you need to have this specific file where which is used to from the model, so from Vertex AI to decide which machine you need to use. And if you don't have this correctly configured, Vertex AI is going to be unable to do it. Okay. But again, you can deploy a model from Hugging Face. The only requirement is just you need to have all this information correctly configured, and also public access, obviously, and that's it. And then what I did is just let's remove the classification filter, the language filter as well. And then what I did is deploy a Llama 3. And then when you click deploy, you go through a model. You can deploy in Vertex AI or in Kubernetes, depending you had already an infrastructure of Kubernetes. You just need to to choose it, and you will essentially deploy this. You need if you had your GKE service running, you just need to copy the manifest file into and deploy the manifest into your cluster, and that's it. If you want to create you don't have an endpoint, you just choose the size. I finally install a 8B001, and you just choose the model, and it will provide you sort of the names by default, and that's it. You just can deploy, and simply you have it. It's taking here also. Keep an eye on this and take a look how much money you are going to spend, because again, just take a look to how much money costs this. You are gonna use a G2 standard 96. Let me 1 second, I will find how much it costs this in my region. Let me 1 second. So let's take a look in my region. The G2 standard 96 costs on demand $9 per hour, and depending on your agreement costs less money, but look, you need a 1 year or 3 years commitment. And take a look as well, is gonna use 8 NVIDIA L4. You take a look as well, let me copy and paste, because we have probably here the price as well. No, not here, and here probably no, as well not. 1 second, GPU pricing, yeah. Sorry. Where is Tel Aviv, Doha, London? Checking your region, Milan, Zurich, London. It's true, I don't have this available in my region, but let's take a look how much it costs. Not available. T4 is 260 CPU, so this means that we have a cost of 1.3 dollars per hour. No, sorry, $1.8 per hour, together with the $9 per hour, because I don't have contract. So this means that we are going to spend, just to deploy the Llama 3, 70 billions, 10 to 11 dollars per hour just to do inference. This is a model with 70 billions. Just imagine that you are going to deploy the Claude 3, the smaller version, with these 300 billions of tokens. Yeah, you can make some calculations on how much money you will spend. But again, I deployed the smaller one, and well, once you deploy, it's taking approximately 30 minutes to deploy. You had a model in your model repository, in your model registry. I had my model here. You can make a test here. Let me check. Just simply sending I think this didn't work. But it doesn't really matter. Let's check. Something wrong with this. I think that was not correct. Well, let me 1 second. I will prepare it again. So here we are. Just sometimes it's the format here is not. You need to be a little bit careful because on when you introduce copy paste from some places is not working properly, and then well, you just can test here the model directly. It's not. You can go to the deploy endpoint. You can click on that. And here we just deployed a model. All the traffic is going to be to this model. And you can, well, the test is there. You can deploy more models in this endpoint. I explained you in a previous video how this works. You had the endpoint. The endpoint is a container which exposes a public IP address with authentication in any case. And inside the endpoint you had deployments. Here we had only one deployment and all the traffic go to this deployment, and you can deploy other models and split the traffic in between models. Once you had multiple deployments, you can edit the settings and just simply change the name settings here at another model and split the traffic in between them and monitor the modding as well, just if you want to check how is the performance of this model. I prepare a small notebook that later on I will post to the repo, and you can find it on the description of the video how it works. You import the library you need. All this stuff is explained on previous videos. I not cover it again. We just use a service account to authenticate against the Vertex AI service. We prepare a prompt. We prepare a request. And just we had this. I took this from the Google Vertex AI repo. You had this sample. I need to change some stuff. Be careful with the location. You need to put the region where the endpoint is deployed, because by default come with Central America, and this may fail. All the API endpoints are deployed based on regions, and in the Europe West 2. So if you are in Europe West 1, for example, you just need to change the Europe West 2 with Europe West 1. The rest keep the same. Also, there was some small bugs on the code, but well, now it's deployed, you will have it ready to go. And then you just invoke the predict the method, and that's it. Let's say prepare here a COT question with Llama 3. I provide it's 256. Well, it doesn't matter, to be honest. It's not gonna do any different. Some temperature, top P, top K, and return raw response. And you just submit the query, and you will get an answer. It's taking a while. And well, it's not answering correctly. Probably we need to, yeah, just take a look to this question. I went to the market, I bought 10 apples. I gave to the neighbor, to the repairman. Then I went again, I bought 5 more apples, and I ate 1 apple as well. How many apples did I remain with? So the answer is 10. Let's check again. Sometimes, this model is well trained for many things, but yeah, in COT, as I posted in some of the videos, I make several tests with models in this size, a little bit bigger as well. Yeah. it's fantastic how these models less provide a little bit less temperature. Let's change the top 3. But well, it's not very reliable in this kind of activities, any model. Oops, what happened here? So, probably we need to, let's change this to 01. It's taking, in my opinion, too much time. You cannot deploy something in these conditions to any project, but okay. Yeah. In any case, yes, really, sometimes let's include a little bit more temperature. But I have to confess that in the initial test I did with Llama 3, you had the video as well on the channel, it didn't work as well. It didn't. I did a fine tuning. Yeah, anywhere wrong. So let's inside, let's think instead. Maybe this way is answering better. But the test I did with the original model without specific fine tuning for COT, the Llama 3 8 billions didn't answer. Now we had 10 apples in there. Now it's working. But we need to introduce the magic sentence, no? Let's think step by step, which force the model to make a breakdown. Well, that is the idea, no? But yeah, then both 5 more apples, now I have, wait, okay, that's correct. Here, I don't know what is including all this stuff. But okay, it's fine. That's all. I hope you like it and enjoy with the video and find it interesting. And well, if it is like that, just give me a like, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, share with your friends and promote the channel and help me to grow in YouTube to make this visible to more people. Thank you very much. See you soon, and I will keep posting more videos very soon. Thank you. Bye bye.